Okay. All right, what else?
I think it's important to acknowledge that she's a lesbian. A lot.
Really?
Actually, that's a good point. I know there's nothing worse I hate than when I'm like around all white people and somehow the issue of race comes up. They all skirt around the issue around me being black. Like it's not obvious.
It's insulting. So I'm sure it's the same way for her. She's a lesbian. Acknowledge it as often as possible.
Excellent advice.
Okay. I agree. Good job.
What about sex?
Okay, what about it?
Well, have you thought about having sex with her?
Yeah, of course.
Well, how do you picture it?
Well, the same way I do with all my other girlfriends. I mean,
no!
Not!
No! Now what?
You can't expect to make love to a lesbian the same way you would a regular girl.
Exactly.
It's completely different.
How could you guys even pretend to know what the hell you're talking about?
Oh, it's common knowledge. Look it up.
I can't believe I'm sitting here listening to this garbage.
Fine. We'll butt out, right, guys? But when you find yourself in bed with Rose and she's not responding to your usual ministrations, as it were, you'll regret not listening.
No skin off our noses. So where's that pizza? I'm starved.
Yeah.
Okay, hold on. All right, guys, look. I mean, look, we're here. You might as well tell me what you know.
Forget it. We don't want to insult you. It's obvious you don't need us.
That's right. You don't need our help. Right, Mark?
Word is bomb, bro. Yes, that's correct.
All right, fine. I'm sorry, okay? Now, just please tell me what you know.
Okay. First of all, you can't make the first move.
I can't.
Absolutely not. Wait for her to make the first move. She's used to being the aggressor.
Hold on a minute. Not necessarily. Tony, is she butch or femme?
I really don't know what you mean.
Is she feminine or masculine?
Oh, she's definitely feminine, I suppose.
You suppose? How can you not know?
What do you mean by feminine? I mean, she's not Anna Nicole Smith or anything.
Well, do you see her as the type to wear more dresses or jeans?
Dresses, without a doubt, dresses.
Sounds like a femme.
Mm, that could confuse things a bit.
How?
Well, if she was very butch, I'd say it'd be smart to let her make the first move. But she's femme, so it's a gray area.
I say don't risk it. Just let her make the first move. It's no need pissing her off right off the bat.
Okay, all right, hold on. Don't make first move.
That also means try not to advance the intimacy. Let her be in control. Okay.
Next issue. How are you at oral sex?
May I ask as to why you want to know that?
It is imperative that you are skilled in the art of cunnilingus. Extremely imperative.
Really?
Oh, yeah. That's how lesbians have sex.
You're stupider than him, you know that?
Actually, Tony, it's true. I mean, think about it. Two women, there's a key element missing. Get it?
A penis? That's it. Forget this.
Okay, wait, hold on.
No.
I have to tell you one more thing.
What?
It's important.
What?
You could hurt her.
Really?
I don't want to get all in your girl's business, but because she's a lesbian, she probably hasn't been with a man in a long time.
Maybe never.
Exactly. So she's going to be kind of tight. You need to be careful.
Especially if you're large.
Oh.
Are you?
Am I what?
Large. It's important. You could really hurt her.
You know, I'm average.
Okay, great. But an average penis can do a lot of damage. I mean, think about it. The average penis is 6 inches long. That could probably hurt a lesbian.
6 inches?
That's the average length of a penis, Tony.
All right, slightly less than average.
Oh.
No! How do I look?
Issue.
whether or not to do it or how it'll feel.
Well, both. But I know I need to be patient, you know, not make the first move.
Absolutely. Right? You cannot kill his male ego.
Yeah, yeah, just let him be in control.
Right, but I'm also thinking about what it will be like to be with a man. You know, I mean, his arms and his chest. It's like his body seems hard.
Yeah. It's gonna be different, that's for sure. What about his,
his what?
You know, what?
She's trying to say his dick.
What about it? Well, have you thought about it?
Yeah, sort of. Really?
Mm-hmm.
What about?
Well, I mean, what to do with it, actually?
What do you mean?
I don't have that much experience with men. The last guy I was with was like 10 years ago. You know, I hope that I'm able to be good.
Good?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, please, how good do you have to be? I mean, up and down and the guy's happy.
Not necessarily.
Oh, yes, necessarily.
Anyway, do you think it's big?
What?
His dick. I don't know. Well, he's a big guy. Yeah, I'm sure it's huge.
Oh, look, oh, God. I don't want to talk about this anymore.
Well, you're the one who brought it up.
I know. It's a fault of mine. I always have this morbid fascination with the grotesque. It's like I always stop at accidents, right? Even though the last thing I want to see is some guy's head being ripped off by a tractor trailer
Jesus.
And dragged 3 miles.
Holly, that's really supportive. Comparing Rose's date's genitals to a decapitation?
That's not what I was... Well, yeah, I guess... Yeah, that's exactly what I was saying. Sorry.
Okay. You know, actually, you guys took it a lot better than I thought you would. Except for Joe.
Oh, look, I'm sorry. She can be such a shit sometimes. But that's why I love her. Actually, I should probably get going. She's not gonna let me back in the apartment with my negative man vibes. So listen, it's not like you're gonna fall in love with him or anything. You know? It's a fling. Have fun. See you later. Bye. Bye, Ronnie.
But I mean, what if it turns into something serious?
Yeah, good one.
That is just it. I mean, I can't relax. I need to be realistic. I am gay. I mean, cut and dry. There's no debate.
Okay.
Holly laughed. You saw Joe. And eventually it'll be you. You know, you'll get sick and tired of going to sports bars with me and my boyfriend, and you'll just desert. Oh, my God. My parents. What am I going to tell my parents? They're not... They can't take change. You know, they're old. They're just not
Rose,
used to
relax.
It.
Relax. Will you relax? What? My goodness gracious. Listen to me. Holly will be fine if and when you fall in love. And, you know, to hell with Joe. We never were thrilled with her to begin with. And you know I love you, no matter what. Okay? Come here. Shit, I actually owe you one. I finally have a date. I mean, now I realize it's with a man. But you know what? I'm a firm believer in momentum. You know what? The offers are just going to start rolling in. It's like a snowball effect.
Wait, my parents.
You know, they'll be fine, probably. You know, relieved.
Great. That's just what I want to do. Make my parents happy.
Listen, I got to get going. You got all that info down, right? Oh, hold on. Don't leave. Let me just check. Okay, don't make first move. Don't ignore her being gay. Be careful not to hurt her during sex.
Don't forget, no flowers or cards. If you need to get her anything, buy her something flannel.
Flannel?
Gay girls love flannel.
All right, flannel. Mark, if you want a ride, let's get going.
Okay. Chill.